Yeah, giggle some more. Are you done giggling? Can we do the intro now?
Sure.
All right. What's going on? Oh my God. Oh my God. Right. What's going on, H2O Army? Justin from H2O Plans, joined with Amanda and Jake from H2O Plans. We're going to be doing an unboxing today, if Amanda could stop giggling so much. And well, we're going to show you what we got in, so stay tuned to check that out.
If you're new here, consider hitting the subscribe button and enlisting in the H2O Army. Also, hit the bell icon to make sure you join our elite notification squad.
Okay, here we go. Jake is getting box number one. We got two boxes here of plants. Amanda, I'm glad I'm paying you to just sit there. It's lovely. All right, here we go. This is what she does. This is box numero uno. Alrighty.
Oh my God.
So those are a bunch of tissue cultures there. A bunch of different kinds. There's a couple of nice ones in there, some Erios, I know that. We'll take a look at them maybe towards the end of the video. So that is big old Anubis.
Heterophylla.
Yeah, Heterophylla. That's actually a special order right there. This is for Serpa Design. He's working on a tank and wanted some big ass Anubis, so that's what we got. Some big stuff there. What do we got there?
Crypt brown
Wendidi. It's a nice plant to put in an aquarium that will provide a different color because it actually gets like a dark brownish color. What do we got there? So that's one of the new ones, I think.
I think it's Sosquascertang.
Yeah, Sosquascertang, and we got a couple little mesh things of it. That was something new that they had. They've been getting some new plants recently, so.
Crypticorn Balancé.
I don't think this is Balancé. I think they mislabeled this. This is Spiralis.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it.
Yeah, this is Spiralis. This is large. This is a new one. I haven't gotten that big of ones in before.
Ruby red jungle bells.
Yeah, ruby red. I said this on our live stream this week, but we don't carry typical jungle bells because these are much better. They're hardier and they look better. They can be grown in low light. Amanda, you could be opening those up, actually contributing to the party. Putting them
in the tank.
Yeah, go ahead, put them away.
This?
Yeah.
Crypticorn Wendidi red.
One step at a time.
So here's a nice little red plant for your aquariums. It'll actually get reddish leaves. So it's similar to the brown, except it has a more red tone to it.
Crypticorn Wendidi green.
And then this is the green variation of all those. Just a bright green leaf, looks really nice. These are mostly all easy beginner plants.
Narrow leaf sedge.
Kind of like a dwarf sedge, but will get bigger and taller. Kind of a mix between a val and a dwarf sedge, so.
Anubis Azelfi.
Yeah, so these Anubis are really cool because they actually have this red rhizome, as you can see right there. They're one of the only Anubis with a different colored rhizome. So those are really neat.
Four-leaf clover dwarf.
Easiest carpeting plant ever. We've already done a video on this. I'll link it above, but you should check it out. Easy, really easy carpet. I've realized that this plant does not like being buried too deeply in sand. It actually starts to rot the leaves in the horizontal runner part, so don't bury it too deep in sand.
Oh, my favorite, Rotala Walichi.
Yes. Very fine leaf stem plant that gets pink and orangey colors. I would actually say this isn't too difficult to grow. It was shaded over there, and it was still growing fine.
I think it's different.
Really? Are you having difficulty, Jake? Tell us about it.
Tell us how you really feel.
Tell us about it.
It looks like a shit-covered stem.
No.
Myrio green.
So Myrio, this is a fine leaf plant, similar to Walichi, but a different species. Really easy plant to grow.
Creeping Jenny.
Another easy stem plant. So we've been selling these immersed grown plants because we're having a hard time keeping up with demand, but I'm only selling the ones that do typically really well. I've actually had to cut a couple of them out because they didn't do well.
Italian Val.
Another really good Jungle Val, thinner leaves than the Ruby Red, but really tall and narrow, and looks really good.
Contortion Val.
Oh, that's bigger than normal. That's huge. Yeah, this is typically, I would say, maybe like 3/4 of the size typically. This is much bigger than normal, so it's really good stuff. This is Contortion Val, big corkscrew val essentially. And that's it has spiral effects to its leaves essentially.
Yeah, hey, more dwarf sedge finally.
Yeah, more dwarf sedge. Woo! We go through this stuff like crazy. It's a really good easy carpeting plant usually. Some people have some trouble growing it sometimes.
Golden Creeping Jenny.
Same thing as Creeping Jenny, except it has a lighter yellowy tone to its leaves, hence the name Golden Creeping Jenny.
Lupus Nail.
Ah, they actually had some. I ordered some of these. We ordered obviously more, but they only had 20, so. Anubis Nana, not much to say about that plant, really easy plant.
More Spiralis?
No, so.
That's actually the Spiralis.
No, the other one's the Spiralis. I don't know. I don't think the other one's Valencia unless.
Unless you can grow that immersed.
Maybe. It might be the immersed form. We got to separate these then.
Yeah.
So this is a Cryptosporalis, supposedly. I'll have to confirm.
Spiralis and like looking like that before?
Well, I've had it come in where they labeled it like that, but I don't know if it's that exact thing.
And a petite.
Yes, everybody's favorite Anubis. How many did I order? 80?
70.
Oh, yeah, I asked them to add on more because Serpent Design wanted some of these too. Tons of Nana Petite. Really easy beginner plant for nano aquariums. It's great.
Cardamine,
which is similar to pennywort, Brazilian pennywort. It can be floated or planted. It's a really cool stem plant. Ah, that's for Serpent Design too.
Oh, that's so pretty.
What the heck are they doing here?
It's
the same plant that they labeled as Valencia, or is it Lancelot?
No, this is Lancelot. It's large, narrow leaves.
That's huge.
So yeah, so if anybody's out there looking for bigger than normal Anubis, we can specialty order it for people. We don't typically stock things that big.
It's like my big boy.
Holy crap.
It's a nice water spray.
Yeah, that's huge. Yeah. Typically it's about half the size, even at the medium. This is nice. What's so funny?
Water spray lace. That's what's funny.
They've been out of this for a while. Really nice plant there.
Crypt Parva, another easy one.
Easy carpeting plant, but it'll take a very long time to carpet, but people do actually make this into a carpet. Since these are grown immersed, their leaves are a lot taller, but once they convert, their leaves are very, very tiny compared, so. What's in the box? Or what's in the newspaper?
What's in the fucking box?
Hey, you can't curse. I gotta bleep that out now.
Go ahead.
Gotta remind myself to go back and bleep it out.
But it's Anacris.
Is it Anacris?
Spoiler alert.
Oh, man.
Or is it Kambamba?
It's Anacris.
Yeah?
Unless they're lying.
Ah, yeah, there we go. Some Eliota. This is Densa. This is the much denser leaves variation of
this one better.
Anacris.
Yeah,
oh, we got some more. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, broadleaf sedge. So another variation of Sagittaria, except this leaf is a lot bigger, hence the name broadleaf. And it doesn't really send out as many runners as the other two, like narrowleaf and dwarf sedge does. So
I haven't seen it send out any.
I've seen it send out runners. It just takes a very long time to.
Lead weights,
because people were asking how can I weigh down my plants? So we have these weights here that you can use, and they're fish safe. So if you need to anchor your plants, here you go.
I know a better way.
All right, that's it for box one.
Have enough substrate.
And now a message from our sponsors. Today's video is sponsored by ourselves, h2oplants.com. It's your one-stop shop for all your aquatic plant needs, including fertilizers, hardscapes, and plants, of course. Head on over there, use the coupon code on the screen or in the description to save yourself some money and help support the channel. Of course, this is never necessary, but we do appreciate it. Thank you very much, and enjoy the rest of the video.
So, unfortunately, I thought we were recording. We weren't, so we already opened this up a couple times, but we got some Aponjiton crispus here, and these things are huge, so I wanted to make sure that we showed you these. Great plant for like backgrounds and bigger tanks, but we also, just a couple of the other plants we got here is Crenum calamistratum here, A bunch of people were asking for these, so we got them in. And then also we got Ludwigia ovalis, and it has some nice variegated leaves there. It's not an actual variegated plant, but it has like variegation to its leaves, which is really nice. But yeah, so here is the rest of the unboxing of number two.
Kleinerbar
swords. Easy red sword. I know it looks green, but the interior leaves will eventually get red, and a very easy red sword to grow. It's really hardy too. It's hard to kill it.
Amazon sword medium.
Yeah, so some big Amazon swords there, as you can see.
Oh, Kabamba.
We got a brick of Kabamba here.
Whoa. Brick of
Coca-Cola. Well, you're talking about Coca-Cola.
Yeah.
I'm talking about stuff.
Jake, gonna have to bleep that.
So my fault I got clogged nose.
Oh. Some nice.
That is nice.
Kabamba. That is really pretty. Need a little bit of that.
We lost our red one.
Yeah,
we did. I'm gonna have to get. Oh no, we have the red one.
We have it in there.
Yeah, we have it over there. That's right. Okay.
People like to confuse.
I forgot.
Kabamba with Lindophilia sessiflora.
Yeah.
No, just talking in general. Aponjiton ulvecius.
Ulvecius. So this goes in that tank over there. Another Aponjiton, but not as big as the Crispus one was. Really nice plant there.
Trident? Yeah, it's just Trident.
Java. Trident Java Fern. That thing is huge. Look at how big that is. Like, this is my hand. That's how big this is.
Just put it next to my jump for comparison.
I was thinking the same thing. I'm surprised nobody said that.
Probably be the same size.
Why do you have dirty minds, Amanda?
What's this? Four-leaf clover clump, regular.
Some regular four-leaf clovers. So these are really easy carpeting plants. This is more so for a bigger tank, but we have dwarf variation if you have a smaller tank.
I'm starting to think that they're chipping us. I'm pretty sure this isn't actually willow.
I think this is willow. I just think it grows in weird.
Because when Adam grew it in, his leaves aren't like thin and long. They're like still like thick.
I think that's just the way it grows under high light. I think under low light, it'll probably have thinner leaves. Maybe. And a high grower willow, really big background plant. So if you have a big tank, like a 75 gallon or a 55 gallon, I recommend it for. Smaller tanks, not ideal for it.
Oh, narrow leaf java fern mats.
Ah, yeah, special order these. They actually got these in. These are narrow leaf. So there's the broader leaf variation, which is those leaves right there. The ones all the way there in the back. Those are the regular, and then these are their narrow leaf. Jake's over there twerking. Oh my god. I want to get needle leaf next, but these are nice. I like these. I gotta get a picture of this.
Oh, you have needle leaf.
Yeah, needle leaf. Well, the problem with it is I can't find a steady supply of it.
Just lace mats?
Yeah.
No.
Well, yeah, it's lace. Yeah, lace. These are huge Java fern lace mats. They're, I think, 5x4 inch, although, is that one, oh no, okay, no, it's just the way it's positioned. Yeah, very nice mats there.
Regular Java fern mats, even though we have four.
Well, I'm selling these by the mat now, on these.
Okay. What, you good?
why do you hate me, Jake, why?
Because you order too many plants.
I don't order too many plants. The people want the plants. Oh, are these the jumbos?
Yeah, these are XL.
Yeah, XL banana plant. Holy crap, those are huge. Those are the size of like a softball. These are, well.
A golf ball?
It's like a ping pong ball.
Well, whatever, they're huge. Extra large banana plant. They're huge.
I'll show you something that's huge.
Listen here, Jake.
Oh, Panjalon
undulatus. More undulatus. This is one plant that I shouldn't have ordered because we have so many of them still, but.
That's what Justin does. He orders a lot of plants.
Them. Yeah. When we don't have.
Plants.
When we have more than enough, we'll order more.
Dwarf baby tear mats on cocoa fiber.
I know, just because a lot of people were asking me for baby tears, so hopefully.
Hopefully, those are nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at that.
Nice.
It's not full, but it's still nice.
Ooh.
That's a good portion.
Yeah, not too bad. I mean, that's a decent amount.
Yeah. I'd pay for that. Honey, don't eat it.
Honey's trying to eat them.
Regular Java fern windelaw.
It's a regular lace Java fern, so we have them separately or by the mats.
More Paris feather.
parrot's feather. This is actually a really pretty stem plant. Once it gets under high light, the tips will get orange, and they'll look really good.
The Copa Caroliniana, I think.
Yeah, this is Carolina. Yeah. So this has the broader leaves than the Bacopa, and actually has it doesn't grow completely straight like regular Bacopa does. Bacopa Monterey or Moneywort grows really.
Hairgrass clumps.
Yeah, these are dwarf hairgrass clumps. These are new. They finally have a steady stock of these. I'm psyched about this. So we gotta separate these. These are gonna be two per portion. So
yeah, two per portion.
Two per portion.
Tiger lotus small.
Yeah, more red tiger lotus. These are great red plants for any beginner. They will get red. We actually have some, I think, in here, don't we?
No, there should be.
Right there floating, that red leaf, that's from one. But good plants there. What's that one?
These are hairgrass mats.
Ah, I want to...
The cocoa fiber.
I don't know if I ordered these from these guys last time or if that was one of the other suppliers.
Oh, that was from this one. Actually... Yeah.
Might be.
Yeah, it's the same.
Same?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that's still a pretty decent amount of hair grass, though, there.
Mermaid weed.
Mermaid weed. So this actually gets different leaf structures from the bottom leaves to the top leaves. They'll actually change color, and they look really cool.
Similar color to the parrot's feather.
Yeah, similar color to what the parrot's feather gets, which if... Can I zoom? Is it going to allow me to zoom? Nope, can't zoom.
Try the plants out.
But it's... That orangey plant there, it's hard to see from here, but...
The Wiggy dark red.
Another reddish plant that's rather easy to grow. Slightly more difficult than like red tiger lotus or dwarf aquarium lily, but it's a Ludwigia. They grow like weeds, because they are weeds.
The Copa Monterey.
This is Moneywort. This is a cool looking plant because it almost looks like bamboo, except it's not like regular bamboo that you can't grow in a fish tank. Because a lot of people, they put bamboo in the fish tank and it can't grow inside of the water. It can grow outside of the water.
Like
but,
a lot of grass.
Yeah.
Mint Charlie. Really smells like mint.
Yeah, so this plant actually does smell like mint, Mint Charlie. If you break like a leaf off or something or touch it, you'll...
Even if you just take it out of the water?
Yeah, if you take it out of the water, you'll smell an aroma of mint. Regular Ludwigia, easy plant, really easy stem plant, one of the ones I'd recommend for beginners.
Ludwigia periwensis.
This one gives us a lot of trouble.
I say we should put it one of the stem tanks. Just one of one or two of the bunch to see what happens.
Yeah. Put in the one on that side.
I have to take that off the website.
I think I took it off already. Because it's transitioning here. So that one we don't sell directly.
Okay, that is Bligra.
That one?
Yeah. So this is the same thing.
Okay, yeah. So then it's getting red at the top? Yeah. I've never seen that. So we have this. We've had this in stock for a while. Nobody's really bought it.
I thought it gets blue.
And it... Well, no, the name... the blue name doesn't really mean anything.
No.
But in our tanks over here, we have it getting a red at the top, which I've never seen before. So that we didn't know if it was actually blue hygro or something else. So, but the leaf structure is the same, you're right. So it has to be a very strange, but really easy high grow plant to grow. Is that it?
Box number two is done.
That's
Stay
it?
Tuned.
All right, guys, thank you so much for watching the video. Unfortunately, we didn't have enough time, really, with this guy. We didn't have enough time to film the wood unboxing because we cleaned up quite a bit. So we want to thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the unboxing, let me know down in the comments below. Maybe we'll do this every week. And let me know what you found enjoyable out of all the plants, which one you like the most. What?
Every week?
Yeah, every time we get a shipment, maybe we'll do an unboxing video.
This guy.
No?
21.
Well, do you
order 25 million in one place?
Whoa!
Drop an F-bomb. We can't use that.
That's how you make me feel.
Gotta redo it.
Get me all fired up when I see a million plants.
Gotta redo it.
Spooky. I'm gonna just throw a chicken.
My crowd.
Yeah.
Entirely.
Wow. It's like I'm not even a real employee. Wow.
I mean, a real employee doesn't just sit there the whole time.
Right.
I was moving.
As you can see, Amanda's still in her chair as usual.
I got back in my chair, correction.
Back in the chair. This is what she does.
Back in the chair.
I sit in the chair for one day.
One day.
That's a whole day you don't get paid.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Hit that like button, share, subscribe if you're new, and we'll see you on the next one.
Bye.
Bye.